Hello everyone. Welcome to Bhadra IAS Academy. Today we shall discuss about the nature of Indian monsoon. When we talk about the climate of India, the one word which comes in our mind is the monsoon. So we shall discuss about the nature of this monsoon. So we know that India is a land of monsoon climate. The word or the term monsoon is derived from an Arabic word mawsim, which means season. Therefore, the word monsoon denotes a season in which the wind regime is completely reversed. For the people of India, monsoon are harbinger of rain. Why monsoon is known as the harbinger of rain? Because the people here are dependent on monsoon for cultivation. So, in simple terms, we can say that monsoon refers to the seasonal reversal of wind from high pressure to low pressure during the summer and the winter season in the Indian Ocean and Indian subcontinent. Because we will deal with the nature of monsoon in India basically. So there are two basic elements of Indian climate, that is the southwest monsoon and the southeast monsoon. So this is the southwest monsoon, which occurs during the summer season. So the wind here blows from the southwestern region, that is from the Indian Ocean to the Indian subcontinent, where there is low pressure because the sun rays are vertical here in the Tropic of Cancer. And the northeast monsoon, which occurs in the winter season, here the condition is reversed, as because it is reversal, it is also known as the retrieval of monsoon. So here what happens, there is high pressure which develops in the Indian subcontinent, as a result of which the wind blows from the high pressure to the low pressure, from the Indian subcontinent to the Indian Ocean. Here, the southwest monsoon winds are moisture laden. These winds are moisture laden as they blow from the ocean to the land masses. While blowing from the ocean, they carry enormous amount of moisture, and as a result of which, these winds causes heavy rainfall in the Indian subcontinent. Whereas the northeast monsoon winds, they blow from the land to the ocean, and these winds are dry. As they blow from land, they cannot carry enormous amount of moisture, means the moisture content decreases. Next is the causes. So what can be the probable causes for such changes? So towards the end of the 19th century, it was believed that the differential heating of land and sea during the summer and the winter season was the cause of monsoon. Eventually afterwards, it was discovered that because of the shift of the position of the ITCZ, which is the intertropical convergence zone. What is this zone? That this is a low pressure zone which is located at the equator, where the trade wind converges. Next is the high pressure over Madagascar, intensive heating of the Tibetan Plateau. We will discuss more about the causes in details in our next or in our later slides. The next are the phases of monsoon. So basically here we'll discuss four phases, that is the onset of the monsoon, the rain bearing system, the retreating monsoon, and the break in the monsoon. So first we'll start with the onset of monsoon. So we can see that during summer, the sun rays are vertical over the Tropic of Cancer. So as a result of this intense heat here in this region, the ITCZ, which is located near the equator, tends to ascend northward to the north of Himalayas. We know that there is Tibetan Plateau here The Tibetan Plateau, which is located beyond the Himalayas, due to heat of the ITCZ, develops low pressure on the surface. So here on the surface, there will be low pressure. But vertically above, the air pressure is high. That is in the upper atmosphere, the air pressure is higher, whereas on the surface, the pressure is lower. Now, we have the easterly jet stream. The easterly jet stream flowing from the east pushes the air from here. It pushes the air through Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea, and then these winds reaches Madagascar here. That is in the southern hemisphere where there is low pressure in the upper atmosphere. Whereas in the lower atmosphere, whereas or in the surface, there is high pressure. So we can see that there is high pressure in the lower surface. Then what happens? Because of the presence of the trade wind, the air, it moves westward. We can see the air is moving westward. And again, when it comes in contact with the Coriolis force, they move clockwise in the northern hemisphere. So here, there is trade wind. And because of the effect of this Coriolis force, they move clockwise in the northern hemisphere, and these winds are ultimately attracted by the low pressure region on the Indian subcontinent during the summer. Here we know that the Indian continent during summer, it has low pressure. And these winds are known as the southwest monsoon winds. Next, when does southwest monsoon enters India? So these winds sets in over Kerala coast. You can see that this is Kerala coast. It sets in over the Kerala coast by 1st June and moves swiftly to reach the Mumbai and Kolkata by 10th and 13th June. By mid-July, the southwest monsoon, it engulfs the entire subcontinent. Now, the rainfall distribution due to the monsoon. So there are two branches of monsoon, that is the Arabian Sea branch and the Bay of Bengal branch. So we can see this is the Arabian Sea branch and this is the Bay of Bengal branch. So we'll discuss in details about these branches. The Arabian Sea branches originate over the Arabian Sea and it further splits into three branches. One branch is obstructed by the Western Ghat, another branch strikes the coast of Mumbai, and a third branch strikes the Saurashtra Peninsula and Kutch. So we can see that this is one branch which is obstructed by the Western Ghat or the Sahyadris. These winds, they climb the slope of Western Ghat from 900 to 1200 meters. Soon, they become cool, and as a result, the windward side of Sahyadris and the Western Coastal Plain receives a heavy rainfall. So this side, after this Arabian Sea branch strikes the Western Ghat, this area, the Western Ghat and the Western Coast, will receive enormous amount of rainfall. And the rainfall will range from about 250 centimeters to 400 centimeters. After crossing the Western Ghat, as they approach towards the eastern side, the amount of rainfall will go on decreasing because the moisture content which they carried from the Arabian Sea, it eventually got reduced. So by the time it reaches eastern side, the intensity becomes less. So this side is known as the leeward side or the rain shadow area. We have another branch of Arabian Sea monsoon which strikes the coast of Mumbai. So this is the coast of Mumbai. Here we have another branch. So this branch, it moves along the Narmada and the Tapti river valleys, and it causes rainfall in the central India. The Chotanagpur Plateau gets 15 centimeters from 15 centimeters of rainfall from this part of the branch. And thereafter, it enters the Ganga Plain and it mingles with the Bay of Bengal branch. The third branch of this monsoon wind strikes the Saurashtra Peninsula and the Kutch. So this is the Saurashtra Peninsula and the Kutch. And then it passes over West Rajasthan and along the Aravallis, causing only scanty rainfall. Here, Aravallis receive scanty rainfall because these Aravallis are parallel to this southwest monsoon. This means there is the Aravallis, it leaves this way. As a result of which, these winds, they pass parallelly to the Aravallis, as a result of which, the Aravallis receive less amount of rainfall. And later on, these southwest monsoon winds, they reaches the Punjab Plain and are joined or mingled with the Bay of Bengal branch, and they causes rainfall in the western Himalayas. Now we shall discuss about the Bay of Bengal branch. So the monsoon winds entering the Bay of Bengal, they enter through two branches. One branch moves westward, entering through West Bengal along Ganga Plain, while the other branch moves up the Brahmaputra Valley in the north and northeast. So here we can see that there's one the Bay of Bengal branch. What happens to this branch is, first this branch will come and strike the Arakan Yoma in Myanmar coast. After that, this branch, it will split into two parts. One part will move towards the northeast, and the other part through Bay of Bengal and West Bengal will enter the Indian subcontinent. The branch which enters northeast, because of the presence of Himalayas, this wind, they will go and this wind will strike the Himalayas, and as a result of which there will be heavy rainfall in this region. There is a sub-branch, and this sub-branch will strike the Garo Khasi Hills of Meghalaya, and Mawson Ram, which is located on the crest of the Khasi Hills, will receive highest average annual rainfall in the world. While the other branch enters through the West Bengal it will move along the Ganga Plain, and further it will reach the plains of Punjab. So these winds, Arabian Sea branch and the Bay of Bengal branch, these will pick up enormous amount of moisture, and as they pass by, the moisture content will go on decreasing, and while passing through places, it will cause enormous amount of rainfall. Next is, it is important to know that why does the Tamil Nadu coast, it does not receive enormous amount of rainfall, because we have seen that here almost most of the states, they receive rainfall, but Tamil Nadu coast, it does not receive rainfall. So what is the reason behind it? First is that one branch moves westward, entering through West Tamil Nadu coast is situated parallel to the Bay of Bengal branch of southwest monsoon. Next is, it lies in the rain shadow area of the Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon. So, the Bay of Bengal branch, it flows parallelly, but the Arabian Sea branch, while reaching this area, the humidity, the moisture content, it becomes less, as a result of which there is less amount of rainfall. Next is the retreating monsoon. So the months of October and November are known for retreating monsoon. So what happens there is, the sun during the winter season becomes vertical over the Tropic of Capricorn. So what happens, by the end of September, the southwest monsoon, it becomes weak, as the low pressure trough of Ganga Plain starts moving southward in response to the southward march of the sun. So as a result of which, the IT sees that it will shift southward. So what happens now? The monsoon starts to retreat. So when does the monsoon retreat? The monsoon retreats from the western Rajasthan by the first week of September. It withdraws from Rajasthan, Gujarat, western Ganga Plain and central Highlands by end of the month. In the beginning of October, the low pressure covers northern part of Bay of Bengal and by early November moves over Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. By the middle of December, the center of low pressure is completely removed from the peninsula. The retreating southwest monsoon season is marked by clear sky. Now, because of the retreating monsoon, there are two important phenomena which take place. Number one is the heavy rainfall in Tamil Nadu coast. Here, because of retreating monsoon, the Tamil Nadu coast receives rainfall. Cyclonic depressions over Bay of Bengal due to the Coriolis force. These cyclonic storms are very destructive. The thickly populated deltas of Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri are their preferred targets. Every year, cyclone brings disaster here. A few cyclonic storms also hit the coast of West Bengal, Bangladesh and Myanmar. However, such cyclonic storms are less frequent in the Arabian Sea. Next, the break in monsoon. During the southwest monsoon period, after heavy rain for few days, if rain fails to occur for one or more weeks, it is called break in monsoon. So the reasons are, the North Indian rains are likely to fail if the rain-bearing storms are not very frequent along the monsoon trough or IDCZ over the region. Over the west coast, the dry spells are associated with days when winds blow parallel to the coast. So that's all for today. For more details, call 8638391721 or visit our website www.bhadraisacademy.in. Thank you.